Welcome to another Blender tutorial with particular focusing on puppetry and video and compositing. In this one, we're going to be looking at a shot here where I have this background here that I don't like and I want to replace it because it's supposed to be a forest and it doesn't look very foresty to me. So I've rendered out a sequence, then go to Blender and import that sequence. No, by the way, we are now at Blender 2.77, but this is exactly the same for as far back as Blender 2.69. First off, it's the same deal. Go to your movie clip editor and open it. Just checking how long the sequence was, 181 frames, so that I can put it into here. To know that our project is 181 frames long, and here it is. I can scroll out, and this is what we're going to be working with. So let's go and set up the node editor. By turning on the node editor with that little button there, use nodes in backdrop so that we can see the backdrop. Delete that one, select delete, and input the movie clip to get a movie that we're going to be working on, which is that one there. To be able to see it, we are going to put an output viewer and connect that into there, and we should be able to see it here. The V key will allow me to zoom out a little bit, and also if we want to see the final output, I can drag that screen out and down here, or you can open another window, but this is the way I like to do it in movie editor, and connect that into the composite. Make sure that your resolution is up at full and that your frame rate is okay. And that's what we do right now, and then push the render button. And here we are. Scroll the button, and yes, there is our output from the composite. And there's our viewer. Now, I want to be able to replace that background with something else. So I'm going to add another input. I could either do an image, but I'm going to put a movie clip in here because I do have an image sequence of some trees, so there's a little bit of movement there. I can open it directly from here, or I can go and search for it, or I can go back to the movie clip editor and import the clip there. I prefer to do that there just to make sure there's no mess-ups, because other people I've tried to teach, that it seems to be something that messes up a little bit. So open the clip, donut, and 7 morning, this background, and open the clip. And there it is. So that when we go back to our node editor, here we can find it in this drop-down node, or this drop-down button here. So now we have a background. To mix the two together, we are going to add a color mix. Because they're both the same size, I can use the mix and I won't have any hassles with the alpha. Turn the alpha on. That's plugged into the background, into the foreground there, and the background. Then you will see there is no change because one is entirely on top of the other. Now we need to mask this. If I put an input of a mask, that's not going to help us very much, is it? Because there's a lot of fine detail there, and fortunately this is fairly static, so we can go over to GIMP and make a mask. In GIMP, I'm going to go and open up one of the other frames that the sequence was in. And I'll open up the first one, for example, because it's a static shot, and there it is. I'm going to duplicate it, just in case. So I'll keep one, and if I make a mistake, I can go back to that, and turn it off. Then I'm going to work on it, this area above there, where it's cut out, this part here. And I'm going to work on this part to make my mask. And then I'm going to use this tool here, to basically select the colors by making sure that I've got feathering on of about 3 to 5 pixels on the radius there of the feathering, and turn this up to about 35, the threshold that is, so that when I click on something like this, it will select those colors, and then I can selectively erase what I want to erase. And then I can get rid of a big chunk of color there. But that did not get rid of the blue and all these bits of trees here. You can get rid of all these speckly bits of off-white also. And then, also down below, I am then going to select the blue, which is there. And once again, with this tool, erase that. And also, I'm going to go in further and all those trees behind there, those yellow ones, I want to get rid of them as well. So I can use the loop tool and just cut those out. Delete, and also I'm going to just also erase right down to the grass there with some feathering on my eraser so that it's going to blend that in. Now you take a bit of time cleaning up the whole thing so that it's nice and clean, and to aid in that you can also add a layer, changing your foreground color to something like red, and add that layer with the foreground color and put it below. Now you can see where the clean and unclean parts are. So go cleaning up, and I'll be back shortly after I've done that task. And so here I have it fairly cleaned up. Nice. So now I'm going to take this layer and duplicate it. Duplicate button. Turn that one off, because now I'm going to turn it into a black and white with colors, and then down to desaturate. Okay, and that will turn it into a black and white. Then colors, brightness and contrast, brightness, and up the contrast, down the brightness, and that'll give me a black and white representation. Okay, to that, and then zoom out, control, zoom out. Then I will also want to fill in the bottom of this here so that it's going to also mask out the foreground, and put my color back to black, and then with the bucket tool fill in the black and just make sure I've got no lines there. Yes, I have a line there, and so, and there. Now I have a nice clean background. Now I can export that to, and call it that back mask, I think. Export it as a PNG, so that now we can go back into Blender and then import it by doing add input image, not as a mask, but as an image. The image, I'm going to open it. There it is. Open it. And there we have our black and white image. Now what I'm going to do now is to plug that into the effect button, and I'm going to take the alpha, not the image, and take and put it into the factor button, and there we have our background. So that's not bad. However, you can see there's a lot of these whitish lines here and a little bit cutty-outy, so we're going to go and fix that up a little bit by going add, then to filters, then one that says dilate and erode. Plug that into the line there and reduce the dilation by 3 or 4 pixels, and it will eat into the edge of that alpha channel. And it's looking not too bad. So now we would like to just make those cutouts a little bit less cut out and have filter, blur, add a blur node in and give it maybe 2 or 3 pixels on the X and the Y axis. And now it's a little bit smoother. And if we zoom in here, you can might be able to see those edges are about the same sort of blurriness as anything else. Okay, now you can take your time in GIMP to make sure that that's all okay. But now we have a color balancing issue. if we can take a look at that. The V key to zoom out, of course, the Alt V, and it's fairly light in the background, so let's take that background, a piece of movie footage, and add a color correction node, and add it to the line so that now on our properties panel on the right over there, see that little plus, the sign there, you can now play around with it. I would probably reduce the gain a little bit to darken it, maybe some gamma, but you've got all these parameters and just play around with it until it's something that you like, something looks fairly similar. Not sure about that one anyway, but play around with it to get your background looking like you want it to. It's maybe a little bit too dark, I don't know. But at some stage or another, you'll see that the little figure there, the mask, will go on top of him as he walks along. He's pretty good so far. There, it's on his bag there. So we are going to have to do some rotoscoping and paste on top. So back to the movie clip editor. Select the original footage, foreground footage, zoom in, and now we can go to the tracking or mask mode, get the mask tool, and basically make a mask that is going to go around the Alt-C to close that, A to select all, then handle type is going to be aligned singles, so that we can shift, drag to give us some feathering on our mask, change that handle type, okay, now we can animate that mask to follow him, just to make sure, I'll make sure that you turn this button on, go a frame or two forward, and reposition the mask. Then go back to your node editor once you've done that along the entire video, and then we can take this mixer here, Shift D to duplicate it, and connect it back into the line, and then take the original movie clip and feed it into the top. And the result was on the bottom and that one on the top. So that is going to patch a piece of original footage within that mask. It is not masked at all, because you can see the background is not there. So we're going to take the mask nose that we had brought in before, select the mask we had, that we've made, and plug it into the factor button. And now it has cut everything else out except for that little patch on the back. Now if you animate that, render that entire thing off, and you're done.